Good evening. We welcome you live to the Sanctuary of Encounter Church on this Wednesday night. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Tonight is the night that the Lord has made, and the Lord is getting ready to ignite us and encourage us for such a time as this. Tonight will be a night of enlightenment in Him. Tonight would be a night of encouragement in Him, and that is exactly what He is going to do. So I encourage you to like, comment, and share. Share, 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 because tonight, as He enlightens you, as He enlightens us, He will enlighten someone as a result and as an act of our obedience. Let me repeat that. He will enlighten someone else and encourage someone else as a result of our act of obedience by commenting, by liking, and most importantly, by sharing. Why? Because our vision is together as one team. And as we share together as one team, God will multiply. Listen to me. God will multiply. I'm going to say it again. God will multiply our reach and our influence. Let me repeat that. God will multiply our reach and our influence, and we can do it together as one team, just like our vision, to encounter the presence of God and to equip people of all backgrounds to become disciples of Jesus Christ, laborers for His kingdom, one united, loving family, having one heart with one purpose, together the world. And that's exactly what He is going to do, together as one team, touching our community and reaching the world. But it's a result of our acts of obedience. The remnant are obedient to the voice of the Lord, and He will have His way tonight and in the obedient. Amen. If you have a youth or a young adult, I invite you to have them join us tonight at 7:20 as our youth and our young adults continue our series, The Author and the Finisher. The Author and the Finisher. So let's gather our families together and let's worship the Lord together as one tonight in Jesus' name.
That's right. Tonight we run to the Father. We run to the Holy Spirit. No matter where we are, we may be in our living room, our family room, our bedroom, wherever we are, Father God, we run to You. We turn our eyes to You, God, tonight. We turn away the distractions of the day, of yesterday, of tomorrow. And Father God, we just want to worship You tonight. Jesus, lift Your name up high tonight, Jesus. And oh, I'm running to Your arms. I'm running to Your arms. The riches of Your love will always be enough. Nothing compares to Your embrace. Light of the world forever reign. Oh, You are good. When there's nothing good in me, You are love, You are it's not just any other name that we're seeking tonight. It's the name of Jesus. So why don't you comment? It's the name of Jesus. It's the name above all names. The name that brings healing. The name above every disease. Every person on earth. His name is greater. His name is stronger. His name brings healing. It brings deliverance. Also, we're going to sing that name, Jesus. And we proclaim it over our lives, over our families, over our loved ones, over our countries, over the nations of the world. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. My heart will sing no other name but Jesus. My heart will sing. My heart will sing no other name. Jesus, Jesus.
Say, Jesus, the name above every name. Every other name will bow to that name. Jesus, the Christ, the Son of the living God. We thank the Lord Jesus, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Lamb of God forever and ever. Church, Facebook friends, good evening. It's our time to pray. So I want you to come into agreement as we pray. Comment, share. We're going to believe God for great and mighty miracles. So many things that we have to pray for. So let's just believe God. If there's a prayer request that's too personal, email the church. But right now, let's pray. Let's pray right now for the nation of Ukraine. Father, we lift up the nation of Ukraine. Father, we pray your protection over this nation. In Jesus' name, we plead your blood over this nation. We come against the forces of the enemy that are destroying and killing innocent people. Father, in the name of Jesus, we ask, Lord God, that, Lord, you're a merciful God, but you're also a holy and just God. And we say, Lord God, no more innocent deaths in the name of Jesus. Lord, we ask, Lord God, that you, Lord God, would give the opportunity for Putin's heart to change. But if not, Lord God, that you would bring him down in Jesus' mighty name. All of his leaders, Lord God, give them the opportunity. But if they don't turn, Father God, bring them down. Bring this nation down to the submission of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, have your way, Father God, and save the innocent lives in the nation of Ukraine. Father God, be give them a roadway in the wilderness. God, you're the way maker, Father. Make a way where there was no way in Jesus' mighty name. And we pray for President Zelensky. Father, continue to give him wisdom and strength and perseverance and leadership, Father God, for the people of Ukraine. And we thank you for him. We thank you for his stance, Lord God, for righteousness in Jesus' name. And now let's pray for the nations of the world. Father God, we pray for all those that are oppressed right now, tortured, persecuted, in Jesus' name. Father, give them strength and grace that they need in this day, Father God. Father God, we pray the same thing, for evil leaders must come down in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, Lord, you want us to live in peace. You want us to submit to you and you alone. So, Father God, have your way, Father God. Sweep across the nations of the world, Father. Let your peace reign and reside on these nations. And Lord, bless the people, Father God. Bring them together, Father God. Give them protection and provision and strength and life in the mighty name of Jesus. And now we pray for our nation. Lord God, we pray for the United States of America. Father, we need you, Lord God. We pray against the spirit of division and strife, Lord God, and violence and destruction that the enemy has loosed. Right now, let's come against Satan and every principality and power, wickedness, power and spiritual wickedness from his domain. Father, in the name of Jesus, Satan, we come against you. We come against you right now. The Lord rebuke you, Satan. Every one of your principalities, powers, darkness, and spiritual wickedness, in the name of Jesus, we render you helpless. We command you to leave and come down from your throne. For the Lord rebuke you, and the blood of Jesus is against you, Satan. The blood of Jesus is against you, Satan. And Father, we ask, Lord God, for peace and reconciliation. Father God, for racism to be gone from our nation forevermore, Father God. And let us join together as one nation under God. Lord God, let us come back to your biblical principles, to stand on your word, Lord God, and be the people that you've called us to be. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray for our president. Father God, give him wisdom. Father God, give him a lot of wisdom in this day and hour. The Lord, that he, Father God, would hear your voice, Father God, and make decisions according to your plan for us. And Father, we pray for our senators and congressmen, for our governors, Lord God, for our mayors, Lord God, for all those in authority, Father God. We pray for our bosses and leaders on our job, Lord God. Father, we ask that you would give them wisdom. And now, right now, let's lift up the fivefold ministry. Lord, in this day and hour, Father God, we pray for every apostle, prophet, evangelist, pastor, and teacher. Father God, we ask, Lord God, and we pray and believe you, Lord God, for life and strength and renewed strength and health, Lord God, to reside upon them. Father, let the word of God well up out of their belly, Lord God, for this day and hour. Lord, we need to hear the voice, Father God. Lord, let the prophet see, Father God, and speak. Let the apostle declare and decree. Let the evangelist reach out into the darkness and pull them in. Father God, let the teacher teach and the pastor love. Father, we thank you for everyone called by you, Lord God. Bless them. Bless their spouses, families, Father, children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren. God, give them strength in this day. Heal their bodies, Lord God. Heal their minds. Quicken them, Lord God, by the Holy Spirit, that they would know the times that we are living in. Father God, let it be all about you. Father, we pray for the churches. Father, all the churches across the nations, Father God of the world. Let us come together, Father God. Let us put you, Lord Jesus, first and foremost in everything that we do. Father, let us surrender our services to the Holy Spirit and be led, Lord God, by you. Father, we thank you and we bless you, Father. Have your way, Father God, especially in these last days. Raise up a remnant army, Father God, an army that stands, an army that knows the times, sons and daughters of Issachar. Father, we thank you, Father God. We call Encounter Church blessed. Blessed, Lord God, blessed of the Lord. We thank you for every member, Lord God, every new member that's coming. Father God, we thank you for your hedge of protection. Father, for the healing of your people. Father, we thank you, Father God, for prosperity, deliverance, Father God, healing, Father God, in Jesus' name. And Father, now we pray. Let's pray right now and come into agreement for our spiritual father and mother. Father, we pray for Apostle and Pastor Joni. Lord, you blessed us with the best, Father God. Continue to use them. Continue to use them as an oracle of Almighty God. Continue to place revelation in their heart for the church in this day and hour. Continue to give them passion and strength, Lord God. Renewed strength, Father God, in Jesus' name. Father, I thank you for your hedge of protection that surrounds them, the blood of Jesus that covers them, and that no weapon that formed against them will prosper in the mighty name of Jesus. And now let's pray. Let's pray for others that are in authority. We pray for our military right now. Father, protect them, I pray. We pray for our police officers, firefighters, border agents, Father God. For those, Father God, doctors, nurses, first responders, Father God, correctional officers, Father, all those in authority, Father, we ask your blessing upon them. We ask that you would speak to them. We ask for encounters, that they would have encounters with you and great discernment in this day and hour, that the enemy will not take them out prematurely in the mighty name of Jesus. And we pray right now, let's pray for our schools. Oh, our children need protection. So let's come into agreement right now. Share, comment, lift up the school that your children's go to. And let's agree right now. Father, we pray for our school system, from Father preschool all the way through to doctorate degrees, Father. Father, these schools, Lord God, our people, our children are being taught, Lord God. They are our generation, the generation now. So protect them, I pray, Lord God. Use teachers to speak, Father God, truth, Lord God. Father, realign things, recalibrate these things. Father, we pray for our principals and our administrators. Lord God, let them see and speak the word of the Lord. We pray for your presence to rest down upon our school systems. We pray against violence and drugs and drug addiction and bullying and cyberbullying in the name of Jesus. And Father, we thank you that our kids are protected, that they are yours, that they are yours. Call upon the Lord right now, church. Lift up your son, your daughter, your granddaughter, grandson, great-grandson, great-daughter, in the name of Jesus. Satan, you have no authority, and you cannot have our children, in Jesus' mighty name. And now let's pray. Let's pray for the roster, and let's pray for our prayer request. Father, we thank you for Encounter Church. We thank you, Lord God, for what you're doing in this house. Father, we thank you for the remnant to arise in this day and hour, Father God. We thank you, Father God, for hearts, Lord God, that are fixed on you. We thank you for deeper devotions, Lord, with you, for greater hunger, greater passion, greater love for you, and greater love for one another. Let us be one, Lord God, in divine unity. Let us walk together in unity, in Jesus' name. And now let's agree. As I hold these prayer requests before you, I want you to stretch your hands towards me. I'm going to touch this phone for all, every prayer request that's commented right now, for everyone that's going to be emailed or has been emailed. In the name of Jesus, just say, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, all we have to do is believe. All we have to do is believe and speak it out. In the name of Jesus, we thank you. We thank you that it's done in the mighty name of Jesus. And now let's pray for our Sunday service. Father, we thank you, Father God, for this Sunday service. Father, we ask that you would have your way and move mightily, Lord God, as you have and will continue, Father God. Our heart, Father God, wants more of you. Father, we're hungry. We're hungry to hear your voice, to receive what you have. And Father, our desire is to please you in everything that we do. So, Father, we thank you. Use this, Father, this Sunday to touch lives here in the sanctuary, those across that are plugging in through the internet. Father, have your way, Father God. Change us, Lord God. Mold us, Lord God, into the remnant, into the five wise, Father God, in Jesus' mighty name. And now, let's pray right now. Let's pray against those that are sick in body. Father God, we pray right now for those that are afflicted physically, mentally, Lord God, emotionally. In the name of Jesus, we thank you for healing. We pray against cancer, heart disease, viruses, afflictions, COVID-19. Dry and die in Jesus' mighty name. We pray, Father God, for minds, Lord God, that are double-minded, that are out of line. Correct them, Father God. Line them up according to your word. Father, we pray, Father God, that our families, our neighborhoods, our nations would be safe, Father God, in Jesus' name. And now, let's come into agreement right now for souls. For souls. Everyone that you've been believing God for. Everyone. God desires for none to perish. So don't hold back. I want you to comment names. I want you to cry out to God. Cry out to God. Lord, give us souls. Lord, give us souls. Use us, Lord God. I pray for a burden, Lord God, to be placed upon our hearts for new souls, for new converts, and Father, for rededications in the name of Jesus. Pray for your family. Pray for your neighborhood. Pray for your coworkers. Pray for all those that you run into in Jesus' name. And Father, we thank you. Church, I want you to give the Lord a great big hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
No other name but the name of Jesus. No other name but the name of the Lord. No other name but the name of Jesus.
A shout of praise. Give him a shout of praise. Whoa, thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, for hearing us tonight.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord, for not turning a deaf ear toward us, but hearing us.
Yes.
And delighting in us and hearing our hearts.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Father. And as Joe prayed, Lord, touch everyone even now, Lord, from the crown of their head to the soles of their feet. In Jesus' name, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. We love you, church. We really love you. What a team this is. What a remnant team this is.
Yes.
The remnant is strong. The remnant is healthy.
Yes.
And the remnant doesn't go away.
No.
Joe, the way, not only the way you prayed, but your heart before God.
Amen.
The sincerity of your heart before God.
Amen.
Is what ministers to the Lord more than anything. And you couple that with the fire of God upon you, the anointing of God.
Yes.
When you started praying for souls, it's like, dear Jesus, souls, souls, souls. That's what it's all about. Folks, today I applied for Medicare. Do you believe that? Because 3 months out before your birthday, you can apply. Today I applied for Medicare. Life's just flying by so quickly. So quickly. And the older I get, the more I put things in perspective and the more I prioritize. And it's really about souls, 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 eternity. For the Ukraine, not just to be healed and protected now, but for the eternal lives, for their salvation. In the mighty name of Jesus. What a great team. Pastor Eddie right now, Kayleen there with the youth and young adults. Pastor Derek, great job, anointing. What a great heart this house is. I'll say that again.
Yes.
What a great
yes.
heart
yes.
this house is. Somebody comment that. What a great heart this house is. Thank the Lord.
Amen.
We thank the Lord for you so much. God bless you. We love you so much. Thank you, Pastor Derek. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Come here, my girl. Oh, God is so good.
Amen.
God is so, so good. Yeah,
Amen.
Joe prayed.
He did.
After
he...
that bombing over the hospital ward, the maternity, in the name of Jesus, it's got to come down.
Jesus' name.
Mm-hmm.
In Jesus
we speak
name.
Blessings over the people of Ukraine and even
yes.
over the people of Russia.
Yes.
You know, there are a lot of godly people in Russia who are under this dictatorship.
Yeah.
And Lord, like Joe said, either save them or get rid of them, Lord. In
Dear
the name
God.
Of Jesus.
Dear
yep.
God, amen.
That's what war is about, church.
Amen.
Amen. Anyway, good to see you, my love. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good.
How was your day?
My day was excellent.
Good.
Good day.
We started
day.
Out together. We prayed together
mm-hmm.
in the morning, prayed together at night.
Yeah, I love
and
that.
God is so faithful and God is so good.
Mm-hmm.
And yesterday, what was yesterday?
Yesterday was our baby's birthday.
It was what?
Our baby's birthday.
Yesterday was our baby's birthday. We're talking like it's our son.
I know.
But our grandson.
Yes.
Charlie, yesterday he turned 1 year young.
The pasta king.
The pasta king. Spaghetti king.
Yeah.
If you've seen on Facebook, we took a little video of him in a pot, in a spaghetti pot, with an old-fashioned wooden spoon, the kind that my mommy used to hit me with when I was young. My mother used to hit me with that wooden spoon, or with a wooden spoon. And here he is. We put a video on Facebook of him eating the pasta. The spaghetti, the
he
pasta
loves,
king, spaghetti king.
Pasta.
And thank you for all of the nice comments you've made
yes.
for Charlie, the blessings that you've spoken over
so
him.
So beautiful.
The gifts,
thank
the
you.
Blessings, every one of them, everything you do is a gift. Everything you do is a gift. And we
mm-hmm.
thank you for that.
Yes.
All your words of encouragement, those are gifts. And Janelle thanks
absolutely.
You.
Absolutely.
Mark thanks you.
Yes.
We love you so much. Yep.
We do.
He is the pasta king, spaghetti king. And Maricel Garcia, how's mama doing? How's mama
yeah.
doing? And not sure if you're still in Puerto Rico or not, but our prayers are with you.
Yes, absolutely.
And
we
our
pray
prayers,
for her.
Yeah, praying and believing God.
Amen.
And we're believing God for all mamas.
Amen.
And papas. And as Joe prayed,
precious,
as Joe prayed over the whole roster.
Yes.
So whether we say your name or not, we got you covered.
Yes. That's right.
He's got you covered.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You know, when, hi, Jeffrey. Love you so much. Patricia, love you so much.
Mm.
Hey, Johnny, let me give you a word, Johnny. Johnny Sharp.
Yes.
Let me give you a word from the Lord, Johnny. It's really simple. This too shall pass.
Amen.
So keep passing the test.
There you go.
This too shall pass. So keep passing the test. That's the word of the Lord.
Amen.
That's the word of the Lord.
Amen.
You know, Sunday, the power of God was so strong in this house for Holy Communion.
Yes.
Wow, was it strong.
It really was.
And I felt like a new anointing on me,
mm-hmm.
a stronger prophetic than ever before,
mm-hmm.
a stronger apostolic than ever before.
It was present.
It was present. And the Lord reminded me today. He reminded me today when Bishop Harris passed away, he gave me three words, you're stepping up.
Mm.
And he didn't tell me anything else. You're
or
stepping
explain
up.
It or anything.
Didn't explain it. But now I'm seeing it.
Oh, yes.
You're stepping up is what the Lord spoke to me when
Amen.
Bishop went home to be with the Lord.
Amen.
And God's raising up radical warriors.
Yes.
Warriors by his word. By his word. Love you too, buddy. By his word. Thank you, Lord. Now, this Saturday night, what are you going to do before you go to bed? Remnant people don't need to be reminded, but we're going to say it anyway. What are you going to do before you go to bed on Saturday night? Let's see who's the first to comment. Pastor Derek, tell me who the first one is to comment. What are you going to do on Saturday night before you go to bed? Who's going to be first to comment? Let's see who's going to be the first. Who's going to be the first? Who's going to be the first? Radical Warriors. Yep, Pastor Gina, Radical Warriors. Who's the first?
Amy's the first.
Amy. Yep, Amy, we love you, honey.
Sherry.
Nancy.
And
Amy. Marina. I love you, sweetie pie.
Yes. Praying for you.
You tell your kids they are champions
yes,
in the Lord.
Yes, they are.
We love you, sweetie pie. They are champions. Patricia says she's going to... Patricia, she said, I'm going to brush my teeth.
Yay!
Yay! She's going to brush her teeth. I like that. That came out of nowhere. Bonnie, you got it. Brush your teeth. You know, last year for Christmas, our son, yeah, Donna, Maricel Torres, yep, Maricel Garcia, Eileen, yep, we're going to spring ahead, yep. Maureen, happy birthday, sweetie pie.
Yes, happy
birthday. I wanted to tell you on Sunday, but you were in the other room doing such a good job. Lori in Texas, yeah, we love you, Lori. Yeah, Marina, yep, you're very welcome, sweetie pie, Marina.
Love you, Marina.
But last Christmas, JD got us electric toothbrushes for Christmas.
Yeah,
electric toothbrushes.
Good.
And when I got it, there you go, Cora. Cora, we love you. We love you all.
We love you all.
But last year he gave us electric toothbrushes. And when he gave it to us, you know how it is. It's like, oh, okay, thank you. You know, you appreciate every gift you receive. But I thought, you're welcome. You're welcome. You got it, Mitch. You got it, Nydia. But I thought, you know, I'm old school. I take the old-fashioned toothbrush and the toothpaste, and I'm old school. But he gave one for Pastor Joni, he gave one for myself, and I really appreciated it. So I said, I'm going to give it a try. One of the best gifts I've ever received in my life. How many of you know sometimes God gives you a gift, but you have to unwrap it? And you have to use it. And you have to use it.
That's right.
You have to use it. And so I've been using that electric toothbrush ever since. Joe, I know you use an electric toothbrush. I know you do because you and I in Branson, we share the room together. You and I in Branson, I seen you use your electric toothbrush. And I forgot mine at home, so I asked him if I can borrow his, and he said, no. Pastor Eddie and Pastor Derek, they share the room together. And Joey Spapari and I, we share the room together. Now you say, why'd you have Joe share the room with you? Because he doesn't snore. I don't snore. Joey doesn't snore. Now, either you may say different, but that's between you guys. But when he was with me, he didn't snore. Hey, Annie Boehner, we love you, honey.
We love you.
We miss you. We miss Mama.
Too.
In the power of the might, you guys are well. You guys are
Amen.
Mighty warriors.
Amen.
You guys are mighty
yes,
warriors.
Are.
Yes, you are. So anyway, I've been using that electric toothbrush ever since, and I love it.
Yes.
Patricia Glass, thank you for the information about brushing your teeth. You see what you started here now?
So then we're recommending that maybe you try an electric toothbrush.
So if you want to use, hey, if you want to go old school, hey, just brush your teeth, all right? Hey, you went to the dentist today, didn't you?
I did.
You went. You know when the best time to go to the dentist is? The best time of the day? 2:30. Tooth dirty. Tooth
Herdy.
Dirty. 2:30.
Tooth dirty.
You get it? No apostle, Ida says, no apostle, I snore, not Joey. I'm the one that snores. Ida, thank you for your honesty. Thank you for your honesty.
Ida, you're so honest.
Thank you. And again, I don't know where we're going here, but between Patricia brushing her teeth, Ida snoring, anyway.
Amy's laughing.
We're gonna spring ahead. That's right.
Yes, we are.
We're gonna lose an hour, but we're gonna gain more power.
That's it.
Yep.
That's it.
There you go.
And I say gladly because I love spring.
Patricia's saying, that's right, Ida. Cover your hubby. It's a girl thing. Hey, this is what? Women's month? Let it be women's year. You know, we thank God for the women of the church.
Yes.
We thank God for the women of the kingdom. Amen. To the ladies, we couldn't do it without you.
Right.
Ladies, we could not do it without you. Mm. We love you so much. So, yeah, Bishop Harris, when he passed, God said to me, you're stepping up. And this Sunday, I just felt, Sunday, I just sensed this new anointing on me.
Yes.
I really did, to the glory of the Lord. So anyway, what else is going on, babe?
This Sunday coming up at 10 o'clock is going to be service right here in the sanctuary. Children's ministry is going to meet as well.
It's going to be powerful. I just know it. Mm-hmm. I mean, they're always powerful. We know that. But listen, it's going to be extra powerful.
Amen.
Somebody comment, extra powerful. Really,
last week, this past Sunday was powerful.
It was. People ran to the altar.
Yes.
Ran, remnant people.
Yes.
You know, God's putting a challenge on us.
Yes.
He
certainly is.
To go from the crowd mindset to the congregation to the committed to the core. And that's for all of us. That's for me. That's for all of us. And, you know, the Lord's a general. He's the commander in chief. And many times in our American culture, we don't like the way the Lord speaks to us because we expect him just to be, you know, what would be a word? Just to be
easy?
Easy breezy.
Yeah.
Easy breezy. And, you know, the Lord always ministers with love, and we always minister with love, but the Lord is our commander and chief.
Yes.
Yes, he is. Remember that song we used to sing, Pastor Derek?
Mighty warrior.
Mighty warrior, dressed for battle.
Holy Lord
of
all is he.
Holy Lord of all is he, commander and chief. Leads us into battle.
Bring us to attention.
Bring us to attention.
Lead us into battle. To crush the enemy.
For we know.
For he has no
authority here in this place. He has no authority here. For this habitation was fashioned for the Lord's army.
Presence.
No authority here. And then we said that
and
Jesus has all the authority, right?
Amen. Yes.
Jesus has all the commander-in-chief, bring us to attention. Commander-in-chief, bring us to attention. And he is.
That's right.
For it's time for the army to raise up like never before to another level.
This is our hour.
Yes.
It's an hour
this
of
is
power.
Our hour.
Yes. Amen. I love you, girlfriend.
Amen. I love you.
I'll see you later.
Bye-bye. Love you.
All right. Well, church, it's no secret. By the way, I love you all, in case I didn't tell you. You know I do. But how many know it's good to be told? I love you with all my heart, that is. Okay?
Love hearing it.
Love hearing it?
Yes.
I love you guys with all my heart. I really do. Hey, Michelle in California. I haven't heard from you in a while. Glad to see you joining us tonight. We love you, sweetie pie. And God's got you covered, honey. No need to worry about anything. No need to fear about anything. God's got you covered, sweetie pie. You're precious in the eyes of the Lord. Yes, you are a soldier for Jesus. Yes, you are. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Well, it's no secret that I love bread. No secret. I love Italian bread. I mean, I love. Talk about weaknesses. My number one weakness is chocolate. That's why I try not to eat it. I try not to eat it because I love it so much. When I say love it, you know what I mean. And sometimes when I eat it, I overindulge. I overindulge. But another thing I really love is Italian bread. And my favorite Italian bread is what they call sesame semolina bread. And I cannot get sesame semolina bread from too many places in Chicago. There's lots of good Italian bread in Chicago. Caputo's has good bread, but my favorite is sesame semolina bread, just baked.
Italian style.
Italian style sesame semolina bread. Well, I found a place on Gulf Road, and near Arlington Heights Road. It's called Valley, V-A-L-I or V-A-L-L-I. Now, there's a Valley in Hoffman Estates, and there's a Valley in Arlington Heights, okay? I'm referring to the Valley Produce in Arlington Heights, Illinois, because not everyone here is from Illinois. So those of you watching from coast to coast by the power of the Holy Ghost, we love you. We call you blessed. But Valley Produce on Gulf Road in Arlington Heights serves the freshest Italian sesame semolina bread. And they bake it, and it comes right out of the oven, and it's so hot, I can eat a whole loaf. I can eat a whole loaf. Now, why am I saying this? Because more importantly, right before service, probably at around 5:30, God gave me fresh bread out of the oven. Fresh bread out of the oven for you tonight. Fresh bread.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Italian sesame semolina has nothing on the Word of God. When I woke up this morning and I prayed different prayers, but the Lord's Prayer, give us this day our daily bread, it was fresh out of the oven. And tonight, I have a fresh word out of the oven baked just for you to digest and receive. It's a now word. It's a now word. And it's a timely word. So here we go. Here we go. In fact, here's what I'm going to do, Pastor Derek. I'm going to ask you, when I call out the verse, I'm going to ask you to come on up here and read it out loud. Okay. Read it out loud. You don't have to, you can stay where you are, but just read it out loud. So you're going to hear him but not see him, okay? All right. You can look up, Pastor Derek, you can look up James chapter 4, verse 1. James chapter 4, verse 1. But here's the fresh manna for tonight. It's not called Italian sesame semolina bread. That's not the title of it. The title of it, and this is from the Lord now, okay? Who are you fighting against? Who are you fighting against? That's the title of the daily bread for tonight that God's given me for you. Many are fighting within themselves. The title again is, who are you fighting against? Question. Many are fighting within themselves. I'll say that again. Many are fighting within themselves. James chapter 4, verse 1 says this.
Where do wars and fights come from?
Where do wars and fights come from? Remember, who are you fighting against? Again, Pastor Derek.
Where do wars and fights come from?
Where do wars and fights come from?
Among you.
Among you.
Do they not come from your desires for pleasure?
Do they not come from your desires for pleasure?
That, or go ahead. That war in your members.
That war in your members. I'm not going to interrupt you. Say it out loud one more time, Derek, even louder.
Where do wars and fights come from among you? Do they not come from your desires for pleasure, that war in your members?
Mm-hmm. So first of all, when we talk about who are you fighting against, first of all, there's a war taking place inside of you and inside of me. It's against our members. Now, what do you mean members? Your soul is at war with your spirit. Your spirit is at war with your soul. Your body's at war with your mind. There's a war taking place within you. Paul said, the apostle said, the things I want to do, I don't wind up doing. There's a war that takes place. So there's a war that begins within yourself. And that's why it's important to crucify the flesh so that our spirit will win the war. Listen to me. Listen to me. When you allow your spirit to win the war by renewing your mind and crucifying the flesh, that is the will, the emotion. When we say the flesh, we're not talking about hurt your body, okay? But when you crucify the soulish part, when you crucify your mind and bring it into subjection, when I say crucify your mind, I mean put on the mind of Christ and take off the natural mind, the carnal mind, and put on the mind of Christ. When you relinquish your flesh's desires, then your spirit person prevails. Your spirit woman, your spirit man prevails. And we are in a war where God wants our spirit to prevail against our flesh, because your spirit does not get offended. your spirit does not get offended. Now that reminds me, and I'm leaking, but I don't know when, but soon I'm going to preach to you about the spirit. Because many times we quote Jeremiah and we say that the spirit is wicked, deceitful, above all things, who can trust it? I'm going to take that verse and I'm going to share with you what the rest of the Bible has to say after that verse was shared by Jeremiah. Because Jeremiah also said that there'll be a day that God will put a new spirit in you. All right? The word of the Lord says that we have a divine nature and a new creation. So many times I hear preachers, I read in books, people quoting Jeremiah that the spirit, who can trust it? It's deceitful. It's wicked. Folks, your spirit is not wicked unless you're not born again. You have a new created spirit within you. I'll stop there until I preach some more on the human spirit. But until then, James 4:1, one more time, Pastor Derek, out loud.
Where do wars and fights come from among you? Do they not come from your desires for pleasure that war in your members?
So the members, there's a war going on with your mind, your heart, your soul, your flesh, your emotions, that is. And when the spirit man rules, when the spirit woman rules, you don't get offended. You don't get bent out of shape. When your spirit is in control, the Bible says he who joins himself to the Lord becomes one spirit. Pastor Joni and I are one flesh, and that's a mystery. Pastor Joni and I are one flesh, and that's a mystery. How much more of it is it a mystery when you become one spirit with the Lord? So if I'm one spirit with the Lord, there's no wickedness bonding together. Righteousness and unrighteousness, how can any two walk together unless they're in agreement? You see that? So there's a war taking place within you. And your spirit man, woman needs to prevail. Because your spirit wants to give. Your spirit wants to learn. Your spirit is filled with humility. Your flesh is filled with pride and arrogance. Your spirit wants to serve. Your spirit wants to love. Your spirit wants to give. Your spirit wants to talk nice about people. But there's a war taking place within you. And then we wonder why there's a war in America, why there's war in churches. It starts within. Somebody comment, it starts within. This is a fresh word from the Lord for you. Not to be entertained, but to be trained. Not to be entertained, but to be trained. Folks, I don't mean to be preaching at you, but I have passion to tell you the truth.
Thank you, Lord.
Because I love you. He loves you. It's a fresh word. Sometimes when I go to that Valley supermarket and I pick up that fresh loaf of Italian bread, I get more than one loaf. Because by the time I get home, half of it's already eaten because it's so hot. Yeah. It smells so good. The aroma. Tonight I'm giving you something that's good that you can eat and eat and eat and yes. eat and taste and see that the Lord is good.
Yes, Lord.
So who are you fighting against? And don't be quick to say the devil. Because there's a war within you first. Some people are going after devils without going after their flesh. I'll say it again. Some people are going after devils without attacking their own flesh first. You got to crucify your flesh first. All right. Romans 8:1. There are those now. Many are fighting within themselves. But then there are those who are fighting against themselves. I'm talking to somebody tonight. This is a fresh word for somebody, for all of you. Many are fighting against themselves. Romans 8:1 says this.
There is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit.
Ah, therefore there is now. Somebody comment now. No condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus. But the rest of the verse says, to him or her that walks by the Spirit, not the flesh. That's why there's a war taking place in your members. We just read James 4:1. There's a war taking place inside. But when you live by the Holy Spirit's leading, when you're in fellowship with the Holy Spirit, then that war against yourself will stop. You will stop condemning yourself. You will say, devil, you're not going to condemn me anymore. You're going to tell your mind, I am free from condemnation. Read it out loud one more time, Pastor Derek, please.
There is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus.
To those who are in Christ, not about Christ, not of Christ, but in Christ. There's a difference, one with them.
Who do not walk according to the flesh.
Who do not walk according to that sinful nature. The sinful nature, the unrenewed mind, the emotions out of control, the fear, the doubt, the unbelief.
But according to the Spirit.
But according to the Spirit. So many are fighting within themselves, and many are fighting against themselves. And if you're fighting against yourself, claim Romans 8:1. Therefore, there is now no condemnation. And if it keeps coming back, then go back to James 4:1. And remember, there's a war that's taking place, and you may have to crucify some things in your life to believe that you are free from condemnation. Somebody comment, I am free from condemnation. But you're only free from condemnation, according to Romans 8:1. You're only free from condemnation when you step into the spiritual realm and get out of the natural realm. Did you hear me? When you step into the spiritual realm and out of the natural realm. And we all go through it, including me. Oh, why did I say that? Oh, I hope she did not take me wrong. Oh, I hope I said this right. Oh, mamma mia, it can go on and on and on. You get it, folks. You get what I'm saying. And we can become so insecure. We want to be sensitive, yeah, but we don't want to be insecure. So many are fighting within themselves, and many are fighting against themselves. Okay, that's just my foundation for where we're going. We are in a season of war. Now, right away, you're thinking, yeah, Russia, Ukraine. Hold on. That's just a part of it. We are in a season of war. So I have to ask everyone a question. And I'm not saying this to insult anybody. And if you do get insulted, crucify that flesh. Because there's a war. Even when people preach, there's a war. But we are in a season of war, folks. And catch this by the Spirit. But the question is, whose team are you on? And don't be quick to comment, I'm on God's team. You may want to be quick to listen and slow to speak before you respond on this one. You may continue to comment, but just don't automatically say, I'm on God's team. Well, are you really? Well, I want to believe you are. In fact, I believe you are. But when we get done with this, we'll have a greater understanding how much are we on his team. How much are we on his team? See what I'm saying? You could be on the team, but sitting on the bench. You could be on the team, but in the dugout. You could be on the team, but not watching the game. Okay? You could be on, paleti yasata. You could be on the team, but not know what the score is.
Oh my. That's true.
All right.
That's true.
So whose team are you on? It's easy to quickly say, I'm on God's team. I'm on God's team. But like Michelle is saying, God help us. That's a good comment. God help us. Now, just to go back in time, 22 years. I'm going to go back 22 years just for a minute. And then we're going to speed up 22 years later. But 22 years ago, the world experienced Y2K. It was 22 years ago. The world was coming to an end. Computers were going to crash everywhere. People were buying up. I know some people to this day, 22 years later, they're still paying for their generators. 22 years later, they're still paying for the generators that they never should have bought in the first place. I prophesied, prophets of God prophesied, Everything's going to be okay. But what did it do? It caused chaos in the world. Hear me. It caused chaos in the world. It caused chaos in America. And it caused chaos in the church. We had a family then that ran, literally moved. They packed up everything out of their house, not an apartment they were renting, a house that they owned. They put everything in their trunk and they moved to the hills of Arkansas.
Yes?
Yes. They moved to the hills of Arkansas.
Yes.
So going back 22 years ago, there was chaos in the world, chaos in America, and chaos in churches. Who was saying Y2K is going to destroy the earth? And who was saying, let's have church on New Year's Eve?
Right. Yeah, come on.
Yes. Okay, let's go forward. Who are you fighting against? Whose team are you on? Today, we have civil unrest, racial injustice, black, brown, white, blue lives. There's so much to comprehend. There's so many battles taking place which should be meant to bring us together to create unity has created division. Black, white, brown, blue, this life, that life. And the enemy has done anything and everything he can to divide us. And I'm not saying this lightly because every color is important to God.
Yes.
Blue lives matter. Black lives matter.
Yes.
Your life matters regardless of who you are.
Yes.
But we're fresh word from the Lord. Who are you fighting against? Whose team are you on? Are you on the white team? Or are you the black team? Or the in-between team? Just an example. Okay? We have social and political wars. Like never before, we are in a social and political war. Protests, marches, we're at war. We're at war. And I'm not necessarily coming against all of these things. I'm not. Because some things are needed. Some protests are needed. Some marches are needed. But the question is, who are you fighting against? And whose team are you on? But the Lord spoke to me this past week and said, we're going to march in March. And this past Sunday, this past Sunday, right here in this house, at 600 West Lake Street, in case some of you have forgotten the address.
It's safe.
Come on.
Unless some of you have forgotten where we're located.
Come on
now.
This Sunday, people ran to the altar, and I prophesied, we're marching in March. Yes. Why? Because we're in a war. And people ran to these altars, flooded these altars, saying, that's me. I'm a remnant warrior. So there's war everywhere, folks. There's war everywhere. Political, social. Teachers. Schools. Strikes. And I'm not coming against who's for a strike or who's against a strike. I'm saying there's a war within it. For goodness sake, we even have baseball on strike. We have baseball on strike. Like the owners are not making enough billions. The players are not making enough millions. Even in America's pastime. What do they say about America? Apple pie? Chevrolet and baseball. baseball, apple pie, and Chevrolet. That's what the saying used to be, at least. I'm not sure if it's okay to say anymore. If it's offensive, please forgive me. Strikes, Republicans, Democrats, liberals, conservatives, the left, the right, CNN, Fox.
Everywhere you turn.
Everywhere you turn. Folks, true story. On my phone, I have a lot of apps. A lot of apps. And one of my apps on my phone is CNN. One of my apps. No, please don't hold that against me. Okay? But one of my, you think I'm joking? I mean, I may not be talking to you, but somebody else in somebody else's house. Okay? I also have Fox. So, a preacher came to my house and my phone was open and he saw my apps. He said, "You have CNN on your phone as an app?" I said, "I do. Honest to God." He said, "What kind of Christian are you?" Then when he saw Fox, he was able to breathe easier. Folks, I'm not playing. I'm not taking sides. There's evil everywhere. Let me ask you again. Who are you fighting against? Because if you're a foxer, you should be a boxer in the kingdom of God. If you're CNN, it's all corrupt. One may be more corrupt than the other. I don't know, but they're all corrupt. Politicians, corrupt. We love governor. We submit to those in authority. We love them, we pray for them, but most are corrupt. Yeah. Who are you fighting against? Whose team are you on? Republicans, Democrats, war, liberals, conservatives. First of all, what is a liberal? Everyone has their definition. What is a liberal? I mean, if a liberal means I'm free in Jesus, I can sing, I can dance, I can shout, I can praise. If that's what a liberal is, that's what I am. Stirring up some stuff here, isn't it? Eating some bread on the way home? Still hot, isn't it? All right. The left, the right. Ba-boom, ba-ba. And you know what the left and the right they're doing? Here's the left, here's the right. Here's the left, you know what they're doing? You know what they're doing? They're beating themselves up.
Yes.
They're beating themselves up.
Mercy, Lord.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I'm going to give you a heavy, heavy word. Here goes. This heavy stuff. America is at war with Americans. Yes, we care about Ukraine, but I prophesy America is at war against Americans. Listen to me. And the church is at war with churches. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Come on. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Come on. Listen de la Palo Santa da Baba Kata da Busa. America is at war. America is at war against Americans. And the church is at war against churches. And if you don't see it, you're blinded. If you don't see it, we're blinded. So don't be quick to say you're on God's team until you find out what the qualifications are to be on God's team. Don't be quick to say you're a remnant unless you're willing to lay down your life.
Come on.
There's a reason why Gideon had 32,000 and ended up with 300. There's a reason why there are only 120 in the upper room when Jesus fed thousands. All right. Then there was the Chinese virus. No, it was the coronavirus. No, it was COVID-19. You see where I'm going? I'm just throwing stuff out there, bait, to show you where we're at. Bible says everything shall be shaken. Yes. so that which cannot be shaken shall remain. Jeremiah said, is not my word like a hammer to break the rocks in pieces? I'm saying stuff tonight to break the rocks in pieces. So your spirit will win and prevail. Because you'll never, hear me, you'll never travail until you prevail. I'm prophesying now. You'll never travail. You'll never prevail until you travail. We have a lot of travelers, but very few travailers. I'm speaking to the nations tonight. Yes. 37,000 deaths in Illinois due to COVID. 37,000 in the state of Illinois. I'm not going to list all the states, but 67,000 deaths in New York State, COVID. In the United States of America, just under 1 million, just under 957,000. That's just under a million, right?
Right.
957,000 in the United States of America have lost their lives to COVID in America. Worldwide, over 5 million. I'll say it again. Worldwide, over 5 million have lost their lives. We're going someplace with this. So we went from quarantine. I'm not going to quarantine. I'm going to quarantine.
Right.
We went from, I'm going to keep my church open. No government's going to tell me anything. That place is going to stay open. To, let's close down the church for a season and let's go on Facebook Live. I'm just throwing it all out there. I'm throwing it all out there. I'm throwing out the good, the bad, and the ugly. And may the godly stick.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Social distancing? No social distancing. Masks? Anti-masks. Vaccines? Anti-vaccines. I'll give you another category here. I'm just throwing it out there, folks. I'm not being political. I'm being prophetic.
Yes.
I'm not pathetic, but prophetic.
Yes, you are.
Illegal aliens? Undocumented refugees. Wall? No wall. Here's one for you. This will hit home. This will hit you in the purse, the pocketbook, wallet. Gas, fuel, oil, Russia, quarantine. Here we go, folks. You ought to do your homework. You ought to study. Hear me. You ought to study to show yourself approved unto God. Don't live your life based on your political affiliation. Live your life based on the infallible word of God. Fossil fuel. Keystone Pipeline. Somebody's saying he's really telling the truth tonight. Keystone Pipeline, drilling, no drilling. Natural energy, climate change, the environment. You see where I'm going, folks? Talk about bipartisan, huh? We'll see. The truth is going to win tonight. I said the truth is going to win tonight.
Yes, yes, yes.
Not the Democratic Party or the Republican Party. Or the liberals or the conservatives, the truth. Somebody comment the truth.
The truth.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you, Jesus.
NATO? No NATO. Sanctions? No sanctions. How many sanctions? Send U.S. troops to Ukraine? Don't send them. Send fighter jets to Ukraine? Don't send them. Guns? No guns. constitutional rights, constitutional wrongs. Oh boy, if there was ever a time where any religious folk tuned in, tonight would be the night for them to get either set free or something. Folks, listen to me. We are in a season of war. I just threw these things out to you. Say, well, you say, Apostle, where do you stand? I stand on the word. Yes. Seriously. We're in a season of war, and whose team are you on? So now you see why I keep repeating, whose team are you on? Because if you're on the Republican team, you're on the wrong team. If you're a Bidenite, you are on the wrong team. If you are a Trumpite, you are on the wrong team. Abmanta la se pe tata lo pola se taka somanta. America is at war with Americans. And the church is at war with the churches. John 10:10. The thief comes but to steal, kill, and destroy. Okay, now we're getting to the root. The thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Pastor Derek, 1 Peter 5, 8 and 9. 1 Peter 5, 8 and 9. Be sober. Be sober. Church, it's time to get sober. 1 Peter 5, 8 and 9. Read it out loud, Pastor Derek.
Be sober, be vigilant.
Be what?
Be sober, be vigilant.
Was the V word what?
Vigilant.
Vigilant. Well, for the last year, the V word I've been hearing is vaccine. Vaccine, either for or against, either way, but vaccine. But what's the V word there, Pastor Derek, out loud?
Vigilant.
Vigilant. Comment vigilant, and don't just comment it, declare it. I don't want you just to comment to comment. I want you to make it a declaration when you comment. Be sober. Get out of that drunken stupor. Go ahead, Pastor Derek.
Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, walks about like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour.
Be sober, be vigilant. Your adversary is not your political association.
No.
Your adversary is not the color of somebody else's skin.
Right.
Your adversary is not Russia.
Right.
Your adversary is not the liberal or the conservative or the left or the right or the right or the left. Out loud, Pastor Derek, please again.
Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil.
Your adversary, the one who hates you, he opposes you. He comes against you. He spits in your face. He wants to curse your children.
Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, walks about. He walks about like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour.
Walking about like a roaring lion, seeking someone to devour. You know what devour means? It means to demolish. Doesn't mean to take a bite of. It means to demolish. Read one more time, Pastor Derek, out loud.
Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, walks about like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. Resist him.
Resist him. Verse 9, resist him, resist him. Somebody comment and proclaim, resist him. Don't make a comment just to make a comment. Proclaim it, resist him, exclamation mark. Go ahead, or say it out loud, resist him. Go ahead.
Resist him, steadfast in the faith.
Steadfast in the faith. Not with fear, not with unbelief, not with strife and division. Resist him in the faith. Go ahead.
Resist him steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same sufferings are experienced by your brotherhood in the world.
The same sufferings that what you're going through, others before you have gone through, and they made it. And you're going to make it.
Yes.
You're going to make it.
Yes.
You're going to make it.
Yes.
You're going to make it. 2 Corinthians 2:11. 2 Corinthians 2:11. Mm-hmm. Resist him, resist him, resist him. 2 Corinthians 2:11, Pastor Derek, out loud, please.
2 Corinthians 2:11.
2 Corinthians 2:11.
Lest Satan should take advantage of us, for we are not ignorant to his devices.
We should not be ignorant to Satan's devices. We should not be ignorant to Satan's devices. I'll say it again. We should not be ignorant to Satan's devices. We should not be ignorant. That word ignorant from the Greek, from the original, not me, the Greek, says idiots. We should not be idiots regarding the work of the devil. If you're blaming your president or past president or the right or the left or CNN or Fox, you're thinking like an idiot. That's what the Bible says. Don't be idiots. Jim DePalma, don't be an idiot regarding the strategies and the tricks and the schemes of the devil. Don't be ignorant to Satan's devices. Paul says, you're not ignorant. He said that by faith. He says, please don't be ignorant. Because many were. That's why he said it. Many were. That's why he said it. Don't be ignorant to Satan's devices. 2 Corinthians chapter 10. I'm going to read. 2 Corinthians chapter 10. Listen to this, folks. You've read this before, but you're hearing it with a fresh revelation. 2 Corinthians 10, verse 3. For though we walk in the flesh, we don't war according to the flesh. Remember James 4:1, the war taking place in your members? For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war according to the flesh. Verse 4, listen. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, they're not of this world, but they're mighty in God for the pulling down of strongholds. For the pulling down of strongholds. This is not the time to pull down your president. This is not the time to pull down your apostle. This is not the time to pull down the prophet. This is not the time to pull down the evangelist, the pastor, teacher. This is not the time to pull each other down. This is not the time to pull each other down. This is not the time to pull America down. This is not the time to pull the church down. But it's time to pull down the strongholds of the gates of hell. Yes. So I ask, whose team are you on? Or whose team were you on? After tonight, whose team are you on? Casting down every high imagination.
Yes.
Casting down everything that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. And bringing every thought captive into the obedience of Christ. So I ask you again, who are you fighting against? Is your mind working for you or against you? Is your body in subjection working for you or against you? Verse 6, being ready to punish. Punish! Punish! Punish every disobedient act so that your obedience is fulfilled. Pastor Derek, get on the keyboard, please. So that obedience is fulfilled. It's time to fulfill obedience. Gio said it best up here on the platform on Sunday. It's time, Holo Santa da Boko, to fulfill our obedience. Not our opinions,
right.
Our obedience.
Yes.
And come, let us reason together.
Yes.
Come, let us reason together. Because now who's being blamed for this? Who's being blamed for that? If we had a different president, if we had a different pastor, who does it sound like? The Jews, right? In Egypt, the Jews in the wilderness. Complaining, complaining, complaining.
Yes, yes.
God's looking for travailers. Talking to the remnant tonight. I know this message ain't for everybody, but it is for somebody. Santo che le pede pada bu santa da baka. In Ephesians 6, verse 10, I'm just going to start reading. Finally, brethren, finally, most importantly, be strong in the Lord and the power of his might, and put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Hear me. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in heavenly places. This is Satan's fivefold ministry. That's where the war is, church. Therefore, take up the whole armor, not a part of it. Take the time, put it on. You're worth it. Take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in evil day. And having done all to stand, stand. That's remnant. Having done all to stand, stand. Stand therefore, having girded your waist with truth, having put on the breastplate of righteousness, having your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel. But above all, taking on the shield of faith, with which you will able to quench the fiery darts of Satan. And take up the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. Praying always. If you're praying always, you don't have time for your opinions. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit. Prayer is useless. Prayer is useless unless it's in the Spirit. And I don't mean just in tongues, but praying with the power of the Holy Spirit, with his help and guidance and aid. Praying according to the Word of God. That's praying in the Spirit. Praying according to the Word of God. That's praying in the Spirit. Not putting people down. Putting devils down. Being watchful. Watchful. Are you watching? Are you watching? Not Fox, not CNN. Are you watching what the Lord is saying tonight? Watchful to the very end. Folks, we're almost at the very end. We're almost at the very end. It's time to be watching. Watching. Don't look around to see what others are doing. Watch. Stay focused. Isaiah said, my eyes are like flint. Being watchful, praying with all prayers. To the very end, with all perseverance and supplication, that's humility, for all the saints. Let me close with this. 2 Corinthians 5:18 says, you and I have been called to the ministry of reconciliation. 2 Corinthians 5:18, you and I have been called to the ministry of reconciliation. That's the team you ought to be on if you're not. That's the team to be on. Because we're in war. 2 Corinthians 5:20, I gave you 2 Corinthians 5:18. 2 Corinthians 5:18, you've been called to the ministry of reconciliation. Two verses later. 2 Corinthians 5:20. We are called to be Christ's ambassadors. We are called to be Christ's ambassadors. An ambassador governs the affairs of a country or is sent as a delegate. God wants us to be ambassadors to our lives, ambassadors to the people we work with. Christ ambassadors. Ambassadors when we drive on the highway. Ambassadors to our employers and our employees. Ambassadors to our church family. Ambassadors to America. Ambassadors to the nations. I'm talking about Christ ambassadors. So how do I know if I'm on God's team or not? How do I know whose team I am? How do I know whose team I am on? How do I know whose team I am on? if you're reconciling and not dividing. And if you're an ambassador representing Christ, not representing your denomination, your affiliation, but representing Christ, governing the affairs of His kingdom. So whose team are you on? We are the remnant. We are the remnant. And the remnant is at war. And the remnant is going to win. Joe, run up here, please. Take 60 seconds. Pray in the Holy Ghost.
Rabba, pray with me. Ramande ke sebere bebe beke tatara bakasa. Rabba babanda rabba babakasa. Reke kere bebe benda rabakosu. Ramondo kusu. Ribiba katara babakasa. Ramama mande ke tere bebe bekisi. Ribiki katora mamanda rabakasa. Rabba babakasa. Let's seal this. Let's seal this right now by the Holy Spirit. Ramande ke tara. Rabba babakasa. In English now. Rebe bebe beke. Lord, let's seal this in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father God. Rabateke sabarabakasa. Kora mamande kese. Kebra mamamanda rabakasa. Ramamamate kese. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lord, seal this word. Seal this word in our spirit. Seal this word, Father, in Jesus' mighty name.
Thanks, Joey. Thanks, Joe. Sealed in Jesus' name. Sealed in Jesus' name. Pastor Eddie, run up here. Seal this word now.
So, Father, right now, we thank you, Father God, and we seal the word that has been spoken right now, Father. In the name of Jesus, the remnant will rise. This is our season. We're going to take what the enemy meant for evil, and we know that you're going to turn it around for good, Father. So we seal it right now by your mighty hand, because of your mighty work. In the mighty name of Jesus, it is sealed, sealed, sealed in Jesus' name. Amen. Sealed into completion, Father. Your word, Father, that encouraged us. Your word that enlightened us today, Father. We seal it, Father God, right now in Jesus' name.
Mighty warrior.
Commander in chief, bring us to attention.
Come on, church, prophesy. One more time, mighty warriors.
Mighty warriors.
Dressed for battle.
Dressed for battle.
Holy.
Holy Lord of all is here.
Commander in chief over the remnant.
Commander in chief.
Bring us to attention. Lead us into battle to crush
the enemy.
Satan has no authority. Sing!
Satan has no authority.
Here in this place, he has no authority. Here for this habitation was fashioned for the Lord's presence. All authority here. For this habitation was fashioned for the Lord's presence. No authority here.
For Jesus has all the authority. Jesus has all the authority.
For this habitation was fashioned for the Lord's all authority here.
That's Jesus now.
For this habitation was fashioned for the Lord.
All authority
here.
Give God a scream. Scream. That's it. That's your fresh bread out of the oven for you, remnant people.
Thank you.
Through the blood of Jesus, God, we come. Purify us, Lord, that we are ministers of reconciliation and Christ ambassadors. That now for sure we know that we know that we know who we're wrestling against and who we're not wrestling against. And now we know for sure, with great assurance, we know whose team we are on. We thought we were completely on your team, Lord, but now we know. Now we know, Lord. Now I know. Now we know. Sealed in Jesus' name. Sealed in Jesus' name. Let's receive tonight's offering now. Let's receive it now. You can go online, Our Encounter. Let's not close the windows of heaven right now. Let's not close the windows of heaven right now. Some of you ought to stop by the church tonight and put that tithe and offering in this box. Why? Seal the deal. Yes. It's not about money. It's about sealing the deal. Yes. You can go online right now. Listen, the bills are paid. It's about sealing the deal. The bills are paid. It's about sealing the deal. You can go online right now to Our Encounter. Our Encounter what?
OurEncounter.com.
I'm so lost in the Holy Ghost right now. Yes. OurEncounter.com.
Yes.
You can swing by the church tonight.
Yes.
If you're making a check, make it out to Encounter Church. You can call the church in the morning. You can even call tonight, but don't leave all the information. I promise somebody will get back to you. At the end of the message, if you call, say, please make sure you got this message because technology, you don't trust it. You can put it in the mail tonight for tonight. This deal is sealed in Jesus' name. We're not paying for a sermon. Jesus paid the price.
Yes, he did. Yes,
thank you, Lord. I love you, family of God. The Lord spoke to me when Bishop Harris went home to be with the Lord. He said, you're stepping up. Now I see it.
Amen.
Now I see it.
Amen.
Now I see it. I don't say this with pride or arrogance, but I'm called to be a general in the kingdom.
Yes, you are.
And he's anointed me for it. And for the abuse that comes with it, he's anointed me for it. The abuse that comes with it, he's anointed me for it. But you guys are the best in the Midwest or anywhere else. And all of you watching tonight, from coast to coast by the power of the Holy Ghost, you've received rhema tonight. You received a harvest tonight just by hearing this message. I'll say it again. You received a harvest tonight just by hearing this message and receiving it. The remnant. Folks, we're in a season of war. So let the remnant arise in war. There's wars everywhere else. Any conversation you have with somebody, there's a war. So let the remnant war. Because the remnant wars to restore.
Yes, yes.
The remnant wars to restore. I love you. Let me give you a holy kiss. Tremendous Thursday, fabulous Friday, sensational Saturday. This just may be a prelude to Sunday, Pastor Derek. Joey, this may be a prelude to Pastor Eddie. Pastor
Joey,
this may be a prelude to Sunday. If you forget where we're at 600 West Lake Street in Bartlett.
Yes.
If you need directions, we'll call us. We'll give you directions. Hybrid church, you're equally apart. You know, some could not, but others would not. You're equally as apart. Love you so much. Church, thank you for being mighty warriors and engaging tonight. Hot word. Bless you. God gets all the glory. Peace. Love you.